Are people getting lazier with their games? You said without all the gameplay. I don't want any gameplay.
Like if I know that from Mario Maker.
If you look at there was Japanese ads for games that were like released in Japan, and the way they advertised the games internally in Japan, mm-hmm. a lot of the advertising slogans had to do with easy to play.
Yeah.
Won't frustrate the player. Uh-huh. Relaxing. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Because they don't really want to do anything. Mm-hmm. They just want to...
Well, I know it from...
do nothing.
Like, I'll get more into this when I try recording Mario Maker later today. Whoa, that guy just shot me ahead.
Yeah.
But I've noticed that people don't want to play levels.
Yeah.
They don't want to get to the end. They like, just pressing forward is hard for people. Like, I can tell because when I upload something... No matter how easy it is, my completion rate will probably be around 7%.
Oh, you know, a good way to actually, like, get data on that is to look at the trophy metrics on PlayStation Network.
Yeah.
Did you ever look at that?
Yeah.
Did you know that in Bloodborne, like, a multi-million selling, copy-selling game,
mm-hmm.
Only about 60% of the people beat the first boss?
Yeah.
Yep. Like, what? Who was buying these games and didn't beat the first boss and then quit?
I don't know why they're buying them in the first place, but...
You had to beat the first boss to continue. Yeah. And then just, it's enough. Goddamn. What's going on?
Yeah.
Remember, back a long time ago, when beating a game was a monumentous thing and you had to tell people?
Yeah, yeah.
I remember that. Uh-huh. I remember beating a game, and I was just like, oh my god, I beat it. And it's just an amazing feeling.
Now,
and I wanted to tell everyone.
Now it's the opposite. Now it's actually the exact opposite feeling. Like, today, if you didn't beat a game, you're ashamed.
Yeah.
And you don't want to bring it up.
I know. It's so weird. Like, I noticed, somebody brought this up to me before, they were saying, are kids getting so lazy now that they're more interested in watching people play games? Like you're doing right now.
Yeah.
Are kids more interested in watching people playing games? And, when you make that complaint, you sound like a dad saying, why don't you go out and play the sport? Like, I realized that, is this how it worked? Kids now want to watch people play games. The kids in the generation before that wanted to play games instead of watching sports with their dad. Their dad wanted to watch sports instead of playing sports, and their dad said, why don't you go play the sport?
Yeah.
I was wondering, is that how it worked? Like, did our great-grandfathers not watch sports and they went out and played the sport? Like, went out and kicked a ball? And then their sons watched sports, and then their kids played video games, and then their kids watched people playing video games.
Yeah.
What's next? Watching people watch... Oh, that's a reaction video. Watching people watch something.
Oh, yeah.
Is something now.
Uh-huh.
After a while, you're going to be watching someone watch something.
Yeah, we should make Etika reaction videos.
Goddamn. Yeah, it's so...
What the...
It's such a copyright quagmire, too.
Uh-huh.
Because people get away with it. Really popular reaction video channels get away with capturing anything they want on video as long as it's not like the whole screen and they're doing something.
Mm-hmm.
And some of them don't even do anything. They just sit there.
Yeah.
And they get away with it.
Yeah. Right?
So maybe we should, I don't know. It's a little
just
risky.
Review YouTube channels. Let's do that.
Review YouTube channels?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I might do that. I'm gonna try
it's
soon.
It's not that funny because it seems like a pretty neat idea, to be honest. Seems like something that would be done by somebody and would make money. I don't know.
Oh god. Reviewing a YouTube channel. And then have the channel's name Review. Oh, it seems slimy somehow. It's weird.
Yeah, yeah.
What a strange thing that is. Imagine if you had a YouTube channel where you reviewed other YouTube channels and you hosted all of their videos with the reaction to everyone.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, God.
And then once you watched all of their videos, you gave them a score and you had your reaction to all of them. It's just like the whole the theft of the whole channel.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder, has anyone stolen any ad videos yet?
Yeah, I wonder.
Sometimes, because I know that certain personalities in the video game industry will steal footage from other people's Let's Plays to use for their documentaries and stuff. And they, people can tell, like, you stole my video. I know exactly what I did there, and you stole it. Right?
Yeah.
I wonder, is because we're so unpopular, maybe someone did and thought no one would notice, and indeed no one would notice.
Yeah. But the video quality isn't on par, I don't think. I think it's just depends. Too bad for people to steal.
Yeah, it's just, these games look fine. They just look how they originally looked.
Yeah, but right. They're not, I mean, I don't know, I'm sure there's some in-depth video nuance that's missing that people look for.
Yeah.
Because we aren't using a $2,000 screen capture thing.
No.
Ooh. Look at these guys bouncing over each other.
But with the PS4, you can actually just record whatever. You know, you can record a video on PS4 and have it capture the microphone audio.
Yeah.
So you can just sit there and make a video when it comes, when your mind, like, just comes around to it.
Yeah.
The PS4 is pretty cool. Like, the other day, I was on the PlayStation Store, and I was messing around, and I was looking up a certain game, and then there was, like, a watch button, and I just clicked it, and I was immediately watching someone play it in, like, perfect resolution. I was like, holy shit, I didn't realize I could still do this.
Yeah.
You can just, if you're going to buy this game, you can just watch someone play the whole thing now on the PlayStation Network.
Uh-huh.
You could, too. You could just watch them play the entire game.
And that's cool.
Yeah.
Because it's better than, I mean, we're so spoiled with the, without having to, like, look up screenshots and stupid shit like that. Like, I remember going to, when I didn't know what the internet was, I would just, like, go to GameSpot and look at their low-resolution screenshots.
Yeah, I remember that.
Judge from that. Or, like, the tiny, tiny screenshots in the Nintendo Power.
Remember, real player? Like, real video player?
Yeah.
In real video format? Uh-huh. And downloading the video file?
Yeah.
And then playing a tiny little shitty-ass looking video of something? Ugh.
Uh-huh.
And sounding like shit. Like, remember when sound was bad? I remember when things sounded awful.
Yeah. I remember just, what felt like a few years ago, you couldn't stream 1080p video.
Yeah, now you can. Friggin' netcode got so amazingly powerful.
Mm.
And, like,
now, like, the one thing that I ever would have possibly complained about, the fact that the, when you're watching an older Twitch stream, you can't see the chat.
Yeah.
They, like, let it record the chat now.
Yeah.
So now it plays back the chat when you watch an older stream.
Yeah, Etika has been recording his chat for a while, and I'm in a few of them saying stuff. Just doing the hand motion like this.
Uh-huh.
Like, thousands of them, with the index finger and the thumb together and the other fingers out.
Yeah. Mm.
Everything is just pages and pages of people, like, doing that little hand motion.
Uh-huh.
And giving everything 100.
Yeah, yeah. Here we go.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Well, stay in first.
I can't stay in first. You kidding?
God damn it.
Just in the interest of, wait. Ah, crap. In the interest of disclosure, Etika is a faggot, and we do not condone that type of channel.
What? Oh, okay.
All he does is react to stuff. Yeah, it's really shady, and I don't like
shady.
But I watched it.
Yeah, but you watched it.
Yeah.
So was it really shady?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I don't know.
Hey, he's that haircut probably isn't real.
Oh, it's probably a prank haircut.
Yeah.
I wish I had a haircut.
You wish you had a haircut?
Yeah. I wish I had. I'd do with any haircut now. You went from first to 29.
I can't.
God damn.
What am I supposed to do? Well, I know I can at least achieve first place now. That's pretty good. All other YouTubers are fags.
Yeah, they're all... You're all fags.
And homosexuality is wrong.
And, every other YouTube channel is, are drunk male prostitutes trying to solicit sex.
Yeah.
Every single one. Uh-huh. They're just trying to solicit sex from drunk men.
They're all 4 feet tall, too.
They're all, yes, yeah. Every one of them is short. They're all shit.
And they have acne scars on one side of their face.
And they're all bald. They're all terrible. My bald just gets worse and worse in every video. When I'm looking at it. It's so bad in the latest episode, like episode 20.
Yeah.
You can see it. It's just like, there's nothing going on there.
And all those other shitty, like, popular channels that are popular for illegitimate reasons, their hosts always have horrible nail-biting problems that they just can't shake no matter what they do. What? I'm not projecting.
Project. I think the video is projecting somehow over the internet.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know what I hate? Overall, though, my least favorite type of channel is top 10 channels. They drive me nuts. It's just like, watch Mojo. Top 10, top 10 worst controllers in video game history. And
uh-huh.
Top 10, but look. And it's just top 10, top 10, top 10, top 10. Mm-hmm. And people just turn them on and leave them go the whole day, I think.
Yeah.
Top 10.
Well, those kinds of things are just so goddamn easy to watch.
What?
Like, imagine just being presented with an opinion, and, like, without thinking, you would just immediately click it. Like, I want to see this guy's opinion on this thing. Well, what is his top 10?
What?
Like,
that's what we should do. We should do a cheaply slapped together top 10 videos for shit.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing I realized was that, I used to think that YouTube channels, in general, you just had to get one breakthrough video that was good, and then people will watch your other stuff. And I realized that's probably not true, because we do have a breakthrough video, but, it didn't really spill over. It's probably spilled over a bit, but it didn't really... fix the channel in any way, like that deer hunt video.
Yeah.
Like, how much of a breakthrough does one video have to be before people will watch everything else?
Yeah.
Like, obviously not. Either that's not how it works, or deer hunt just wasn't big enough. And I'm leaning towards now that's not how it works. I think your breakthrough video, all your other videos have to be like that.
Yeah.
Right. And for some reason, every other video we do has yet to have been like Deer Hunt, and I don't know why.
Hmm.
So that's a potential problem.
What's with that?
I don't know.
I'll need to watch that video again.
I watched it a million times. I don't know what's wrong. I don't know what's different about it. And most people I ask from the channel, when they talk to me, I ask them, what was the first video you saw? And they usually say Deer Hunt. 2005, Cabela's Deer Hunt season, whatever that PS2 game was.
Yeah.
So either our core demographic is people who would have played that when they were kids, So that means people in their late teens to early 20s.
Yeah.
Or people just want to watch videos of video games that no one else has played yet on there.
Yeah.
Because I think it's unpopular. Or it's a mixture of the two. And what we need to do is play things from that came out between 1998 and like 2005 that no one else has played yet on YouTube.
Yeah. Oh God. That's easy. That sounds like.
And we've been going through like every PS2 game.
That sure ain't rocket science.
Oh.
Oh look, I'm almost dead already. I hit a bomb. Ugh. There's also, trying to get a rise out of people.
What do you mean?
Just being controversial in general. I don't know how you do that in video games, but...
I can do that with everything else.
Yeah.
I just don't want to. because I don't want to be killed. So I just... I never tell anyone what I really think about anything anymore.
Because you don't want to be killed.
No.
What is it that you think?
I don't want to get in trouble. Yeah, I don't know what we could exactly...
Yeah, it's... I mean, like, if you had a more general channel, then you could target specific people.
What does that mean?
You know,
no, you don't understand. Everything would eventually become about video games. Because I don't have anything else.
No, I mean...
Probably just... what do you mean? Creating a channel to smear another channel.
To for smear the purpose of people. Like... Just to complain about people.
Oh.
And make sure all your fan base hates the same things you do.
Do people ever get fan bases that aren't like that? That like something that you don't like? I don't think that happens. They're not your fan
base.
Well,
I mean, what if you started... what if you hated something? Then you started, like, hating something else, and most of your fan base didn't agree? And they probably wouldn't... They wouldn't watch the videos related to that new thing.
I was thinking about creating a video game review show that's not hosted by us. It's hosted by CG Models. And it sounds awful. And, it's just, like, really short and bad. It's something that could be done.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about something.
What?
Game theory.
They
present ideas that no one in their right mind would agree with. And that's why they're popular. I think because people just click the thumbnails that have the stupidest opinions.
That's...
or the stupidest...
Yeah, that's the Superman trick. Is to, how you sold a Superman comic back in the day was just like, why is Superman denying these people a drink of water? And, people are, that was actually a Superman comic cover where, Superman was standing in front of a water well, and he was saying, nope, not one drop. And everyone on the ground was thirsty and dying of thirst and crying, water!
I wanna buy that.
We need water! These innocent people, and Superman was saying, you can't have water.
It can't be Superman's fault.
And then the little box at the bottom of the cover was like, find out why Superman won't let these people have water. And everything was like that. Superman's fat. Superman is violently slapped Lois Lane. Superman.
Yeah, yeah.
Superman dating Lex Luthor? What? Superman. And it turns out that it's like solved instantly or something, and then nothing happens. You can do that.
So you could make videos like, or you could just make videos that just generally make people angry, like, why isn't Mario black? And why isn't there a good why isn't there a good Dark Souls game yet? Stuff like that. Why isn't Demon Souls more like its predecessor Dark Souls? You linked me this video once called, Why Are Video Game NPCs Still Racist? That infinitely cracked me up.
Oh, god.
Just
damn.
Reading the title, it just... It was so,
still.
Like, it was so, like, it felt like it was egging me on.
Mm.
It was like, yeah, they were always racist.
How?
Why are they still racist? Answer me that. And you're letting it happen. By being racist.
Yeah. That's like a... I hate nature documentaries because the last 5 minutes is always about how we're destroying nature.
Yeah.
And it's our fault. And you can just cut that
Why are you still doing it?
Why are you still driving this car? Why are you watching this on a TV that took, like, rare earth metals to produce the picture display and... Why? Like, I wish you could just cut off the end every time and then
yeah.
be fine.
Yeah.
It's like somebody flies around in a rusty old rolling coal plane and they take pictures of oil fields and complain about oil from their plane and.
Yeah. People using the internet to learn how to, take them
steal.
People using the internet to learn how to take themselves off the grid.
Yeah, that is strange.
Yeah.
The more I think about it. Yeah, like, it's like
once when do you feel that you've learned enough that you can stop using the internet?
I don't know. It's like driving a car someplace to get it dismantled. And then not having a car to drive back.
Yeah.
I'm destroying my car. Uh-huh. I can't come back with the same car. I was walking and I tripped in some mud and I got splashed and got mud on the very pants I was returning. Yeah. Well, what were you going to wear back? Well, I don't know. I never thought I had that car. That's from Seinfeld. Kramer was... wearing the pants he was going to return to a store and got mud on them. Imagine if you, like, went to a store. I should do this. I should put on clothes that I just bought at Walmart and go to the item returns area and try to return them while I'm wearing them and see if they're going to, like, let me take it off in the store.
Like, or go into the changing room, put on a bunch of clothes, ask a clerk to ring them up, and then say, no, I'm going to wear them out. That's fine. Just leave your clothes there, on the floor. Well, you guys will pack those up for me, right?
What'll happen if you, has anyone ever got caught going to a changing room at a store, taking their clothes off, putting it back on coat rings, and then putting it stealthily back into the aisle with the clothes, and then putting it there. Someone else will come along, see if there's old ratty clothes in amongst it, and just take it.
Or if you want to be, really obtuse, just buy the same clothes and then put the old ones on the rack. And
wait a minute. So if you really knew what clothes you wanted to wear, you could. Save a lot of money by wearing that clothes, keeping it really clean and looking good. And then you go to Walmart, you take the exact same pair of clothes into the changing room where you change and then put the old one back where it was and then buy them as you walk out.
Wait, if you didn't put them back and you had like a backpack or something and you kept them in that, could you leave without anyone... Well, I mean, I guess they have those ink things that...
Yeah. I knew a guy who, he was an older man. He would, like here, for some reason, we have a lot of people who just walk every day.
Yeah.
They're always the same people walking all day every day. Like, retards and old people.
Uh-huh.
And, there was, an older man I used to know who, he bought a pair of boots at Walmart here. And, they had a deal going on there where, if you wore them out in, like, 10 months, you got another, on the warranty, you got another pair free from the warranty. And he actually wore them out.
Oh, yeah.
In about 10 months. These, like, high-quality boots that no one in their right mind could actually, like, these I'm wearing now. There's nothing I could do to wear these out in a few months. And this old guy would actually wear them out. And he'd go up there and get a new pair of free boots every time.
Wow.
And he would get free boots every single time he did it.
So he'd just do that over and over again?
Yeah, over and over again. He did it, like, his whole life.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
How do you wear out work boots?
He was a walking guy. Like, we have people who will walk. Like, I know one guy who was retarded. He, sometimes I'll be driving around at, like, 4 in the morning, and I'll see him just starting to walk.
Yeah.
And then he'll walk, like, all the way to, like, 2 towns over, and then come back, and then finish. There's a few times where I saw this guy stop in the middle of the crosswalk.
I'm so gone.
Like, stop, and then turn around and come back where he was going.
Oh.
He wasn't going anywhere. He just came to his point where he was done walking for that day, and then turned around and started doubling back on the walk to go back where he came from.
Huh. All right.
Yeah, I know the exact guy. He broke his foot, like, decades ago. Mm-hmm. And he thought that God would heal his foot, and he didn't go to the doctor, and he still walks with a limp everywhere.
Ooh.
And he's got long hair down to, like, his butt.
Yeah.
You know the guy I'm talking about?
Well, I don't know who you're talking about, but...
Well, just look for him. You'll see him. I guarantee you'll probably see him within this week, if you actually look around town. He's all constantly, perpetually walking.
So just look for an old man with a limp.
Just look for an older man with long hair and a limp.
Okay.
Like, long hair, and he's... Like, got a really serious limp, because he tried to heal his own foot.
Oh, yeah.
He asked really kindly for God to do it, and God apparently didn't like him.
Yeah.
So, I should just tell him that one day. You know why your foot's still broken? It's because God hates you. He fixed my foot just fine. Look.
God invented doctors for a reason, you shit.
We all know God invented doctorhood and doctoring and God.
If God made everything, then why do doctors exist? Probably because God can't do shit like that.
God doesn't know how to stop diseases, so he made doctors to figure it out.
Yeah.
It's clear. The answer's clear.
I think God can't touch a single thing. No, that's what I think.
Oh, okay.
I think he created everything, tried to tell us what to do, and...
Didn't work.
It took him so much energy to create Jesus that he just... He's completely spent now.
What do you mean? He didn't create Jesus. He created the Easter Bunny who hatched Jesus from a chocolate egg.
Well, that's the same thing.
Yeah.
It takes the same amount of energy to do that.
And, he created the Easter Bunny who laid a gigantic chocolate egg that Santa came out of. And Santa is Jesus on his off time.
Yeah. Santa's Jesus after the hoax that he pulled 2,000 years ago, where they thought he died.
But he just became Santa?
Yeah, he just became Santa.
Oh, that makes sense now.
Yep. So that's why he won't come back. He found himself a job that he likes more than being Jesus.
Do you leave cookies out
less
on
dying.
Christmas Eve for Jesus?
I mean, he has to deal with dying less.
I'm going
to
tell, if I have any kids, I'm going to tell them, Jesus is coming down the chimney on Christmas.
Yeah.
Leave cookies out for Jesus Christ. He's coming. Oh, yeah.
Watch out for evil Jesus.
Is there a good Jesus and a bad Jesus?
I I tried making Jesus the first time, but he fell in with the wrong crowd. And, he had to disown him and try again. That's the one that became Santa. Amazing.
That's the one that became Santa, not Satan. Santa.
Yeah.
Close. In fact, this is, you can just rearrange Santa to spell Satan.
Yeah.
I always thought that was strange.
Yeah. And evil and love, same way.
There's an O in love. You're probably thinking
oh,
live.
Oh, no, live, yeah. Evil and live.
It's not evil.
Yeah.
Love. Evil. With an O. Yeah. And you only have to add one letter to the beginning of laughter to make slaughter.
Yeah. It's gotta be intentional.
Yeah.
God did that for a reason.
God gave us one moon for a reason.
That's why he lets us choke for a reason.
He gave us one moon so we didn't get confused about celestial mechanics.
Yeah.
Do you ever think about what it'd be like if your civilization grew on a planet that had like 50 moons? It was impossible to tell what was going on. And your orbit around your star was really elliptical. So it looked like the sun was getting further away and then getting closer. And looked like it was dancing around in the sky.
Yeah.
Would you advance as fast as a civilization, I wonder?
Yeah, I wonder.
If you were just he looked up the sky and got confused and then didn't look anymore. Because,
imagine if humans were just a little bit dumber.
Our particular planet, the way we have it with our Earth and our Moon, it's really easy to figure out where we are.
Mm-hmm.
But it would be really hard if we were on, like, Jupiter or even Mars, because Mars has two tiny little proto-moons.
Yeah.
And nothing else.
Now, which moon were we supposed to be rotating around this week?
You don't rotate around a moon. The moon rotates around you.
Yeah, but like 2,000 years ago, you might think you might rotate around.
Oh, yeah, you might think that.
You might orbit a different moon every week or some stupid shit like that.
That's what you'd probably think.
Mm.
Imagine if you had more than one sun.
Yeah.
And you orbited two suns. And, the thing about if you're orbiting more than one sun, you would have off years where you switched onto the other orbit and things got really different.
Yeah.
And then went back. So you probably have, like, 20 years of normal weather, and then you'd have an ice age.
Yeah.
And a civilization could never live like that. They could never get to an advanced state.
Uh-huh. It'd be hard enough just living in the cold. I don't even know how people used to handle winter back in the day.
Well, they did. Somehow.
You'd have, like, nothing but meat and maybe certain grains to live on.
Yeah, it is quite amazing where humans live and what they do. It's not a question of finding where they live. Like, if you were an alien zoologist, you'd be looking at humans, and you wouldn't try to figure out where they live, you'd try to figure out where they don't live.